And there is Maria Folau. She's been in pretty good form here in Liverpool so far this week. Of course, both these sides going through unbeaten. And Shani, this is just one of the games that you just can't get enough of.
I know, you can feel the vibe lift within the stadium, Jen, and the Australian-New Zealand rivalry.
As we await the beginning of this game, we're away. Australia in possession as they take on the Silver Ferns. And it not that long ago in January in the Quad Series, just three goals between them that day. But of course, no Caitlin Bassett in that series.
She was out injured in that series, and it is a completely different team without Caitlin Bassett. But you know, this is Australia's first test of the tournament to see how they're going to go, especially against New Zealand zone when they're playing so well so far. But Steph Woods able to sink her first goal for the game.
Of course, interesting thing from a New Zealand point of view, Nolene Tourua, coach of the Ferns, coaches quite a number of this Australian team.
And really getting that insight over in Australia with Noel. She's been able to do so much over with Sunshine Coast Lightning and clearly has done a great job of bringing this team back together again for New Zealand with a point to prove as Folau shoots her first goal.
So just to reiterate why this game is so important, this will decide who finishes top of the group. The final game of today, beautiful screen from the Australians, will decide how England and South Africa finish. And then it's a crossover.
So Australia putting some good defence on here, not letting the Kiwis through easy. Close there for Steph Wood.
Yes, it's hard yak up for the Ferns. Now they get down, Crampton in the corner.
Centre obstruction, outside.
And you see the Aussies trying to squeeze in Ekinagio and Folau into the corner there. And Maria is on as Folau sinks her second.
Let's go, Debbie Fuller, Nolene Tourua, the coaching team for New Zealand. Old mates, Silver Ferns together.
Great double play there between Brown and Bassett.
And look at the speed with which Australia scores.
They don't muck around, do they, Jen?
First turnover of the game.
Great pressure there from Bruce. Being tied on Maria.
Manage contact center. Shooter, sorry.
Oh, and a lucky there from Weston. A little bit of the double tap over. And I think that's the nerves that you can see coming in from Australia. Always takes a few minutes, if not a quarter, for these teams to settle whenever they come up against one another. And Wood taking advantage of having both players out of play.
Australia!
And getting her second for the game.
And this is what happened. Yeah, disruption.
Australia being patient, playing it around, not forcing it in because they know that they don't want to put the high ball in against New Zealand. We know that that's what they want to gobble up for breakfast, so. And a call against Liz Watson there for trying to run in on top.
Kopua will be pleased with that one.
Watson holding her own.
Vantage contact goal defence, Vantage contact wing attack.
Rorty at wing defence today. Oh, look at that from Bruce. Oh, she deserved to carry that off, came through.
It's a great fly from Bruce. We weren't sure whether we were going to see the same tenacity that which she'd had in the earlier games, but she's proved so far she's going to give us something to watch today.
And that was a great dodge by Langman on Jamie Lee Price.
He flies through. Watson just not quite onto it there to be able to pick up. There is some great pressure here.
Massive pressure from the Diamonds, forcing New Zealand back.
Some good effort from Bassett there. No one making anything easy, but Langman always the go-to for the Ferns. Always making herself available. And the high ball gets in over the top of Bruce as Folau
And isn't that interesting? Most shooters would have stepped in. Maria Folau, I'm happy here.
She takes it from there. It's so unlike any other shooter in the competition. And what she's so well known for.
So suddenly, already 5 minutes have just about gone by. 4-all.
Neither side giving an inch. Bassett coming out to open up the circle. Wood happy to double play it. Will she take the shot? She will. She's getting more confident.
100% shooting so far from both sides.
Happy to play it around.
Jamie Lee Price already in a few battles with her old teammate, Laura Langman from Magic Days. Ekanasio, first goal for her. Watson looking down.
Oh, they get the tip.
And that's great work by Rory.
Australia needed to turn on the defence now. Some great pressure there from Jamie Lee Price. Wing defence. They're getting a bit too much contact in there. Weston with her hands high. But the fans happy to play it around. And Bruce again. Getting a tip on it.
What a season she's had, Courtney Bruce. She's had the elbow injury at the beginning of the Suncorp. Set her back for a few weeks.
She's come back in such great form.
That's great work from Weston.
Great work from Weston. And coming back, I think, you know, when you are out with an arm injury, you're able to be able to do some more work on your footwork and that body control, which she's been phenomenal with in this World Cup. Bassett taking the ball strongly. Not letting Kapua get in her way.
Well, the pole takes it pounding. Yeah, great work, that defensive combination for Australia. Yeah, and better work from New Zealand. Well, what a surprise. 6-all, 8 minutes gone in the first quarter. Feels like a final.
It does feel like a final. Well, it is a final.
Of sorts,
anyway, for us to be able to get through to the semis. An unfortunate miss from Steph Wood, and the Aussies now need to turn around, get back in defence, and make it hard for the Ferns to get further down the court. It is the pressure. You can feel it as it goes. And this is the game that we're always waiting for coming into a World Cup. Such a history, such a rivalry in the teams. Brown unlucky to miss that one there. They're going for absolutely everything.
Fabulous clash between Watson and Langman. Of course, they do it day in and day out in the Suncorp.
I think they enjoy that bashing, Jer. They sure do. Folau over the top. As New Zealand go one ahead.
Halfway mark, first quarter. Now New Zealand will want to score off their own.
Weston just getting caught on the body a bit there. As they work it in.
It's offside at the top. Yeah, misfired on the
umpire. An unlucky disadvantage to the Silver Ferns there. As Ekanasio had it underneath the ring.
Contact centre.
Now look at Folau flying round. Not able to pick it up. Ooh.
Bruce not happy with that one, giving a bit of a head shake.
And
I think it's proof.
So biggest margin of the game so far. Two goals.
Every little inch counts, but all about the pressure that you can build.
Interesting backstory to this game. Of course, 4 years ago in Sydney, New Zealand won the group stage match against Australia. But Australia won the big one. So early miss from Bassett, but no problem. She clicks.
And you never know what to expect during these group stages, Jen. You know everyone's going to come out hard, but does everyone show their cards? Do they all go hard? But I think the semi-finals this year are going to be tougher than they've ever been.
Well, it's never in doubt, really, is it, that New Zealand and Australia are going to go hard at each other.
Always. And a great rebound there from Bruce. Into Brown, quick down the court. That's a quick transition they need, so the Ferns can't set up their zone. Then happy to play it around to get it into the goaling position that they want. Price having it to herself there into Weston. Down into Wood. Onto Watson on the goal circle. And into Wood again. She's cruising around the court there and slots it in.
Back they're not on gonna let even terms. Eight all. Just over 5 minutes. And this is where the ball began. That passage down play for the Australians.
And it was because they got the ball down there so quickly. You can't allow the Kiwis to set up. That's their strength. You need to find the open holes. Where can you place it? Where won't they run through on it? Wood in again. Oh, and a great nice shooter to shooter.
Australia, 9-8. Ekenasio nicely off the line.
Great take by Crampton. To get it onto the circle edge there, making it easier for our shooters.
Contact, goal defense.
You can see that's goal a great defense view of that too circle and just how tight it is in there.
People underestimate how hard it is to make space in a circle that size.
Advantage break, wing defense.
No doubt about who they're supporting.
Throw in.
Good pressure, Ekenasio right up on the transverse line. You advantage can see Deb Fuller pointing in the background.
Advantage obstruction, wing attack.
The Aussies advantage are trying to make space, but the Kiwis making it hard. But Bassett holding her space well in the circle and finishing it off.
And what a machine she is, Caitlin Bassett, the skipper.
Standing so strong for her team.
Has been tormenting New Zealanders since 2011.
Yeah.
World Cup in Singapore.
She sure has. And Bruce over the top.
Great tip from Bruce. And there was Jo Weston to collect.
Keeping her body clean. So hard to get around a shooter's body like that. A strong take from Brown onto the circle. Up over the top to Bassett.
Contact goalkeeper.
And the contact there from Kōpua as Wood takes the shot.
Two goals now the other way. Australia, 11-9. Centre pass to come. And that was beautiful work by this defensive duo. Kelsey Brown.
Oh!
Trying to find a way. That's poetry.
That is threading the needle through. And sinks it. Great work from Wood there.
Into the final Barney's 3 minutes, first quarter. The margin is three.
Barney's contact center.
Oh, and our first shirt front for the day goes against Ekenasio against Jo Weston. But I'm sure it's not the last time we're going to see a body on the floor today.
Hold time or you're over there.
It's the physical contest that makes it so tough.
So danger time now for New Zealand. Australia score here. And it's a four-goal lead with the centre pass to come.
Contact, goal shooter.
Oh, and another attacking contact the other way. Absolute coach killer.
Advantage contact, causing win attack.
Kōpua back to help.
Goal attack.
Fans happy to play it around here. Oh, great work by
through Langman. The middle. Just that surge and acceleration. Again, Bruce does well. She's having a great first quarter.
She is wreaking havoc in there for the Silver Ferns. Oh, but an unlucky pass. Need to get that placement right from Jamie Lee Price.
Might have been a good tip, I think, from Folau.
Absolutely. And finishes it off. That is a lifter for the Ferns.
Vantage break, wing attack.
Defense really making it tough for the Diamonds.
Offside wing attack.
Oh,
careless from Kelsey Brown. And this was just a little opening. New Zealand needed Nolin Tarua. Constant talk.
And off the back of their own errors as well. They need to stay strong when they start to get a lead. They're the little ones that you just can't give away.
Contact advantage offside, centre.
Many personal battles in amongst the wider battle.
Contact outside.
And mainly with Langman on the circle edge there. They're giving it all. They're not giving any space whatsoever. And unlucky there.
That was an interesting call. It was an incorrect play of the ball.
It was. Yeah, it was replay with in own hands. You can't pass it to yourself as you tap from one hand to the other. You must rip it in with both. We're very particular in our rules here in netball. But this is where the teams just need to settle. The first team that can settle as another ball goes astray.
From what cut through
the phantom that appeared out of nowhere to keep the lead out to three. And I love the Ferns are happy to play back to Watson here.
Well, they'll be aware there isn't that much time.
Obstruction taken, play on.
They'll want to get it in.
What a first quarter from the Silver Ferns. With 15 minutes gone, it is Australia leading New Zealand 13-10.
Well, one opening quarter here, Australia leading by three, Australia 13, New Zealand 10. Where do you think it's going to be won and lost? That's the championship quarter, is it? Okay, any players impressed you particularly out there? Who? Joe Weston?
Yeah,
okay, fair enough. Oh, I asked you earlier where you girls and ladies were from. I couldn't hear you. Where are you all from?
Melbourne.
You're all from Melbourne?
Proud Melbourne.
Sorry? We'll go to Victoria, sorry. Yeah, okay, Victoria. Perfect. So, how are Australia going to see this all the way through to the end? Obviously, you're going to say yes. How are they going to achieve that, do you think?
Defensively.
It seems pretty tough out there, doesn't it? I mean, it's very hard on both sides to get it through the goal.
Very physical, just athletic.
I know what you mean. Athletic. Yeah, athleticism.
Hey, that's what's going to be the
game. Okay, and do you ladies all play netball back in Australia?
Yeah.
Okay, you all play for the same club?
No, we're all over Victoria.
Of course you are, that's a very big state, as we know. So what club do you play for?
Serpentine.
And who else here plays for Serpentine?
None of them.
All right, do any of you play for the same club? You're all from individual... How do you know... Okay, so how do you know each other?
Just long-time family friends.
Okay, and who's team organiser? So you organise the whole trip. How long are you here for? And then where?
We've been to Italy and London. You were going on to Scotland and some others to Greece.
And you?
Back home.
So when are you going home? Yes. Are you going home?
Well, thrilling end to the first quarter. New Zealand desperately trying to get another goal before the hooter, but it was too late. It was a beautiful goal, but it was simply too late. And that is costly for New Zealand, because when the teams come back, it will be Australia's centre pass, and Australia leading 13-10. This game to decide who finishes top of the group.
Let's go, Diamonds!
Second quarter gets underway. Australia, good first quarter for them. The Diamonds leading the Ferns 13-10. Oh! Jane Watson getting around
the body so cleanly. Australia needing to stay strong if they want to keep this lead. You can hear the crowd. They're so loud. Getting right behind both sides, but there was an Aussie chant just before centre pass was going, and you'll hear them erupt as Caitlin Bassett gets her first for the second quarter. Just needing to chip away.
Oh, I think lucky there perhaps for Lau. Using all of those 3 seconds, but helped by that obstruction call. Back to the three-goal margin. No changes as far as I can see by either coach.
And Caitlin Bassett home alone. And that was a great sight. See into the circle there.
Falau coming well out of the circle to help. New Zealand, though, having to go back using Kaupua. Oh, great defence, Australia.
Really pushing tight for their one-on-one, but a great double play from Falau. Sinking it through and not letting the Aussies get away. Brown open over the transverse line.
Contact goal defence.
Unlucky for Kaupua there.
Well, you could see just about the whiplash from Kelsey Brown as she bumped into Kaupua.
Yeah. I think that's going to be the least of her worries today. Neither side giving an inch. Crampton finding her space.
Not wanting to give it to Falau. Bruce on Falau. Opting instead.
Oh, nearly getting around the body there. Defenders needing to just give themselves that little bit more space to be able to come around.
Instruction goalkeeper.
And Falau milking both of them and getting it through.
Australia!
One for one. Oh, another contest there.
Beautiful from Jane Watson. For me, she has been one of the defenders of the tournament so far.
We heard Nolene say earlier in the week she is one of their spine players along with Laura Langman, and she's stepping up and getting them the ball when it counts.
Oh, she's like a whirling dervish. Hands, legs, everywhere.
As all the best defenders are. It's the unorthodoxness in us that makes them so great.
Falau doesn't miss it again.
She's got her eye in.
Opportunity for Australia. Can they peg New Zealand back again?
They've got all the shooters out of the circle here. That's exactly where you want to keep them. Oh, and Bruce flying for that high ball, but Weston misses one over the top to Falau.
No goal. Yeah. Hell ball. Ball doesn't count. A goal, rather, doesn't count.
She was playing with fire earlier, and that one was a little bit too long.
Goal keep, wing defence, contact.
So costly for New Zealand.
Bandage moving off. Bandage obstruction.
Oh, that was unlucky there. A bit of a trip over Watson's feet from Wood, but called for the contact, and it'll be Wood's pass or shot.
Well, the cowbells are ringing, and I wonder if they've come all the way from Waikato. Australia, add one more.
Making the most of the turnover. Bassett coming out, but not used. Great play there from Watson. And over the top to Bassett.
Construction goalkeeper inside.
Watson having a go at absolutely everything.
Defence with your leg. Backwards goal shooter. Backwards goal shooter. Thank you. And again, where it occurred.
Amazing what the umpires have to keep their eyes out for as the defenders and the shooters get caught in their leg locks and the elbow locks.
Well, I don't know sometimes how they make the decision as to who was doing it to who.
It's true. Sometimes it's just what they see at that current point in time, and it's luck of the draw.
Langman dancing.
She does.
Great pressure from the Diamonds.
Oh, and Bruce over the top. What a great contest there between the Australian goalkeeper and Ekinagio. Really having a go at everything, and Bruce also, as Watson, really stepped up in this tournament, stepped up for Australia to be such an amazing goalkeeper, and is rewarded.
At the Australian fans, Look at this.
Whole time.
Up over the top.
5 goals now between these two sides.
Contact.
Joe Weston playing with the ball.
Footwork, windy fence.
Some little error there. I wonder if you can roll the ball around your arm like windy that, but never mind.
Well, I guess maybe if it doesn't leave your hand, you can do whatever you want, Jen. I think you'd be amazing at it. And the Aussies putting on some good pressure.
Wing defence, penalty. Wing defence, contact.
You can't afford to give these penalties away. It leaves the player open down the court. And if New Zealand do it properly, they should be able to work it pretty quickly down into the goal circle.
They are having such difficulty getting this ball in.
Advantage offside, contact, wing defence.
Man, it's physical.
Everybody on the line. Oh, Bruce reaching for it, but Folau getting the better of it and sinking it through.
And that's Joe Weston going through on the floor, picking up slowly. Now, I think, yes, the Australians, you can see now, just to the right of your screen, desperately calling for the floor to be wiped. Very sensible.
And it's so important to get the sweat off the floor. You don't want anyone running on that. We've seen a few bad cases before of knee injuries if you slipped over on it.
And there's been a few already here in Liverpool as well. So...
Well, have you really played a game of netball if you haven't been on the ground? Good wiping, Bruce. That's really getting around it. Keeping her grounded. We don't want her getting ahead of herself.
Wow,
we know she loves it out in that corner. She can sink it from anywhere. It doesn't take it.
Takes that one.
Australia!
Not fazed at all.
Back to 3 this margin. Australia, though, still in the front. Rory gets
there.
The tip.
Every ball is nerve-wracking.
Contact goal to wing defence.
Rory doing what she can to try and stop Steph Wood getting back into that circle. Not necessarily legally.
No. I also love when a player's out of play and they stand so upright. March of the Penguins.
Australia hit 20. Just about halfway through the second quarter.
Contact goalkeeper.
Some great play there, moving the ball around for the Ferns, getting it in a little bit easier than they have in previous centre passes. Folau.
Folau certainly doing the bulk of the shooting for New Zealand. Ekenasio, 3 from 3. All the rest of those goals coming from Folau.
Kelsey Brown, deep over the top. One of her favourites.
That's it.
7
Vantage
apiece in this quarter.
Defense. Vantage contact, wing defence.
And a good
instruction.
Shooter there from Wood first. To Bassett and through the hoop.
And the Australian shooter's very much more sharing the load, much more even distribution.
Advantage contact.
Between who's taking the goals. Well, she had to get rid of it. She was off balance. But it goes right out the back.
So important to recognise when your players are off balance. You need someone coming at you. Great vision there from Bruce to Brown, getting it down the court.
Vantage causing contact and offside.
Working it around. Ooh, close to a help ball there. I think the Ferns fans are up and about. Oh, and a great take again from Bassett.
Well, this is danger time for New Zealand. Australia out to 22-17.
Kelsey Brown just getting it easily over the top there. Rory's really got to do something to keep her up in front of her.
Just over 6 minutes remaining in the first half. 23-17. The Diamonds.
Contact,
I don't know if I'd say in control, but they are certainly on the up.
Advantage contact,
they are
defense.
Working for every single ball here.
Advantage offside.
But they're not risking it either. They're happy to work it around. Great defense here by the Diamonds.
Instruction goalkeeper. Hold time.
And Bruce angry at herself there, giving herself a hit on the side for getting
where
caught.
The attack is.
Weston needing to watch the pass or shot here. Could go over the top to Folau, but... Ekenasio!
I'll do it myself. Well, Nolene Taurua, you can imagine she will not be happy with this first half. from the Ferns.
Backwards one set. Forwards one set.
She won't be happy.
She's a hard taskmaster at the best of times.
Oh! And what a great pass over the ring, Jen! I haven't seen a shooter to shoot a pass like that for a while!
I bet they practiced that move.
I think it might have been a missed shot, maybe, but it won't go to the stat board because Steph Ford caught it. Steph Ford caught it. Oh, Angman! Just missing it there. Westin coming through. Oh, Rory!
Who's going to win the chase?
A good call there from the umpire. Watson was there first.
New Zealand bench, very vocal. I think everyone in the stadium is vocal at the moment.
Jamie Lee Price!
That's brilliant from Jamie Lee Price.
She's proving her worth here at this World Cup, showing Lisa Alexander why she was picked in the team. I'm here, I'm going to get you intercepts, Lisa, and the team.
Vantage offside centre.
It's like she's been here a lifetime. And a great pull in there.
Well, this is now... Look at this.
And the diamond surge forward.
Advantage obstruction.
Straight in again. Oh! Well done, Korpua. Over the top. That looked like it was going to be an easy in, but it wasn't to be.
But look at the Ferns. They're all camped down on one side of the court. Now they come across. Great defensive work from Australia.
In the centre third.
Continuing to get the ball back for her team.
And New Zealand starting to look a little bit rattled.
Contact, goal attack, centre third.
Wouldn't you love to be looking at those coach notebooks at the moment? I wonder if both Alexander and Tōrua, if they've got set changes that they were going to do at halftime, or with this game, do you run and see how it runs out?
I don't know if you could read it that early. I think, you know, the Aussies are going to be happy with this first half, definitely. Tokopua comes through again to get another tip. And that's why they've brought her back into this side, because she stands up when it counts. She's not going to let him get ahead, but... I just think you can't count anyone out. I think you can't preempt changes. Great tip there from Weston. You can't preempt changes at this level.
I bet... Oh, there's a little bit of note-taking going on. Bailey Mears up. Interesting time to make a change. There's only 2.5 minutes left in the second quarter. But I think a change is what we're going to see. Oh, lovely one-handed rebound from Ekenasio.
And Flau has been the main goal scorer, so I think if Mez is to come on, she's got the goal shooter bib on the sideline there, so we might even expect her to come on before...
Well, I think what she's trying to do, I think she's trying to attract Ekenasio's attention. I think that's the change that's going to happen.
Flau into goal attack, I would imagine. And will they call it here? Yep,
and
there she goes.
Now,
yep, here's the switch at the top of your screen.
Yep.
Just watch the circle.
And Ekenasio is the old point to the knee. There's nothing wrong with me, but Mezzi's coming on. Will this make a difference in the last 2 minutes? What a great take from Crampton.
And I suppose the benefit of making a change sort of late in a quarter is it just you see how it goes, and look, if it doesn't work, well, you've got the break in a moment anyway.
Exactly right.
Further round here. Yes.
It can throw the defenders out a little bit.
Goalkeeper.
Bailey Mears and Courtney Bruce. Well, they've had some memorable games over the years.
Just around there, please.
Particularly one in Invercargill, I remember.
Yeah. And Mezzi's just that bit more aerially strong than Ekenasio, so that's the difference that she's going to be able to bring compared to what she did against a Bruce and a Weston. She's going to hold her ground. And she is a phenomenal rebounder as well, so an absolute asset for the fans to have on court. But
5-goal margin, 1.5 minutes remaining in this first half.
The Diamonds playing some great netball here. Calm, collected, playing it in, pass it under the post.
And there's
exactly
the change for you on the screen. Flau moves out, makes way for Bailey Mears.
Will she have the confidence to put the ball
centre
up?
Obstruction.
Well, you would certainly hope so. Because really, if you haven't got the confidence, you shouldn't be there.
Yes, that's true, but it can take a bit of time to get in. There she is.
Goalkeeper.
Lau slots another.
27-22, 35 seconds on the clock in this first half.
Australia would want to score another before the half time's in, just to extend that margin out. It just gives you a little bit more breathing space. They've got plenty of time with 23 seconds to go. Watson there to sneak in a little bit close, but Bassett just that solid target under the post.
Now New Zealand will want to go like the clappers here. They'll know there's not much time on the clock. Falau looking long.
Oh!
Well, she had to try, but will this backfire? No! One end of the court to the other in the dying moments of this first half. Thrilling, thrilling netball. At the moment, it is Australia leading New Zealand 27, in fact, 28, 22.
Well, the first half, Australia going to the break, leading by 6, half-time score. Australia 28, New Zealand 22. So half-time in this Australia-New Zealand game, and time for a bit of fun and games. Who likes free merchandise? Everyone likes free merchandise, and it can mean only one thing. The Vitality T-shirt. Cannons! Let's bring them out, Ollie and Becky. We need to see you rise up. We want to rise up and show us your catching skills. Ollie's down here. Becky is with Judy down over here. 8 t-shirts each. Ollie, load up. Becky, load up. On my command, has won. Who rolls up? And Ollie, you unleash hell. Oh, that's a good start. Oh, drop to the back. Good take, that walking cat! That was a great cat! Another drop. I don't think we've had a catch on this side yet. Thank you. Very good. We have a little rhythm over here. What's up for the commentators? What's up for the staff commentators? Nice to see you guys. That's got some height on it. Good catch. How many have we got left? Oh, just dropped. That's very generous. Very generous. I saw that. Well done. Well done. So maybe I better just call for the trumpet and the person who picked it up will be better. Just your last one, Becky. Last one, Becky. All right. Nice and done. And there you go. Are you done? We're done. That's it. So I'm afraid those are all the t-shirts we've got for this session. But don't worry, you've still got your Vitality Thundersticks and your gold cards. And you can do come, Tommy. If you don't take them home, the Thundersticks and the cards are recyclable, so please can you put them in the correct bin. Right, let's get some thought from our guests here. Well, what a game. I mean, the first quarter has gone off. Netball World Cup is sitting just starting to get a bit of daylight between ourselves and New Zealand. But is it everything you thought it would be?
It's everything and more I thought it would be. The defensive pressure from both teams is immense. There's literally so little between the two teams. I just think Australia being a bit more consistent and playing the ball around a bit more. And that's why they've got the edge.
Getting the ball into that offensive circle seems impossible, isn't it?
Yeah, I've been really impressed with the combination of Wood and Bassett and just the whole Aussie Garden attacker. They've been really patient, working through that QE zone. And yeah, as I said, the defensive pressure has been phenomenal.
Small margins, as always. to New Zealand find that extra percent.
I think the change in the shooting circle that we've just got on, I think Flau being out of goal attack will certainly make a difference. Yeah, they just need to keep working that combination and trying to get it a bit easier into the circle.
And for Australia, more of the same, or they need to up it again?
No, I think more of the same. They'll be happy at half-time. I think Bruce at the back end, Weston, as well as Jamie Lee Price, have just been phenomenal with that defensive pressure. Bruce have been flying out for balls off right in the centre, so they'll want that to continue in the second half, definitely.
Yeah, it's fascinating watching it. Naughty. Okay. I know it's not. Aww. Are you enjoying it, dude? Yeah? Oh. Very good. What do you reckon? What position did Judy play?
I think it would be a great little centre running around the court everywhere, showing everyone your moves.
Did you go with that?
Yeah, you can have my big dude, I need
to enjoy. Can you play wing defence? Anyway. Of course you can play wing defence. Yes, very good. Well done. Sorry, I'm very slow on the uptake. It's just the top of the game now is so compact. Australia have been leading the way for such a long time. It's just fascinating to watch these two slug it out. It is a slugfest. It's so competitive. Brilliant to watch, isn't it?
Yeah, it's so competitive. As I said, there's so little between these two teams and probably the top five teams in the world at the minute. And it really is just consistency and getting the combinations to work well with each other, which is the difference. It's only the tiniest margins that will separate these.
So you're sitting on the sideline, are you there just picking up little things for your game as well?
Yeah, I've been here for a lot of the week as a fan. I've just really been watching such high-quality netball. And yeah, I've definitely
wrote
down a few tips to
get away on my phone. It's the business end, isn't it, now, of this tournament? And it's just fascinating to watch how the teams react to the pressure. And there doesn't seem to be any reaction, it's just the more of the same. That training just comes into its full right now, isn't it?
Oh, yeah, definitely. This is what all the athletes work towards. The pressure is, when you're in a game, you will not be thinking of it. You're in the zone, you're thinking of the tactics, you're thinking about your teammate and what you can do for your teammate to get you over that line. So don't think pressure will be anything for these guys right now.
Okay, listen, thank you as always once again. Teams are coming back out, so I'm going to move off court. Juice is going to come with me, and we're going to do a cheeky little Mexican wave. Okay, we're going to start down this corner. We're going to start slow, and we're going to work it up, okay? So, G, come on, we'll go down over here. Oh, G's so keen to get this going. Okay, we're going to start in this corner. Nice and slowly. We've got about... Let's see how we can do it. Right, okay, I need everybody to stand up, please. Rise up. Rise up for me. There you go, thank you so much. Right, ready? Slowly. Right, we're starting here, ready? Go. Slowly, yeah, go. Up you go. Up you go. Whoa. There you go. Up there. Very good. And slowly round. In through here.
Guys, come on, we're doing a Mexican wave. I need you to stand up, please. Let's go, there we go. Keep going. Nicely done. We're standing up on this side. Jude, watch out if you come this way, please. There we go, all the way around. Back end there, the back ends. Okay, let's speed it up now. Far corner, let's go. There you go, right across here. Oh, brilliant, lovely, well done, the Australian fans, well done, the Kiwi fans. Well done, Northern Ireland, thank you very much. Round we go, round we go. Is that Zimbabwe up there? Hello, Zimbabwe fans. Keep going. Second half coming up, Australia 28, New Zealand 22. Australia fans, let's hear it for your side, please. This is going to be a great second half. Remember, the winner of this match will top their pool and play their semi-final on Saturday morning. The second place side will play on Saturday afternoon. Don't forget to keep on cheering. Make these players remember this game here in Liverpool. You have a job to do, girls and guys out there. Don't let me down.
In this cracking game between New Zealand and Australia, man of many parts, Dan Ryan, now joining me in commentary. And Dan, Australia, very good in that first half.
Yeah, absolutely. Really solid from end to end and obviously suffocating defensive pressure, forcing the Silver Ferns wide, putting them under pressure, looking quite good in attack too.
So 28-22 as we await the second half. You can see a number of changes by both sides. We'll take you through those shortly. Second half underway. Australia, 6 goals ahead of New Zealand, 28-22. Remember, this is the game that decides where in the group these two teams finish, 1 or 2. And that will decide which way round the semi-finals go. This Alexander yelling at the troops. There's Shannon Saunders now on at wing attack for New Zealand. Bailey Mears did well to get that ball. We saw that switch between Mears and Ekenasio late in the first half.
Yeah, some changes needed to take place in that Silver Ferns front line, and obviously Bailey Mears can be just as effective in that goal shooter position as Folau is. She's a real athlete in terms of getting off the ground, so giving Courtney Bruce something else to think about, and maybe a little bit more punch and drive and speed from the game of Shannon Saunders in that wing attack role.
And that is exactly what New Zealand needed, held ball, because that was what they were unable to do at any time, really, in that first half, was exert enough pressure on the Australians.
Jen, this first 5 minutes in this third term is critical for New Zealand to chip away at the margin, put a little bit more pressure back on Australia. They need to stay in touch because the Australians do have the ability to rip this game open if the opportunity presents itself.
Nolene Taurua looking very thoughtful. She knows, of course, so many of these players. And that's what she will not be pleased with.
That's the danger zone for the Silver Ferns, that second phase connection area when they get it just past the transverse line. It's quite congested and no free space to connect through.
So I did say a number of changes by both sides. That's not true. I don't think Australia have made any.
Well, everyone's bibbed up ready to go, and I think people were really interested to see what would happen at halftime with the benches, but Both teams backing in the lineup that finished that first half.
Australia add one more. And they hit 30.
Opens nicely. Again, that was the drive from Kelsey Brown out the front. She slightly shifted Watson and Coppola at the back, and beautiful vision from Watson to see Bassett under the post. Great decoy drive from Brown.
And the margin moves out to 7. So not the start New Zealand wanted.
Oh, Weston G, she has been good. Nullified Ekenasio.
And that pass was never going to get there from Mez.
Well, it's a sign of a pressure build, isn't it? Sometimes, you know, you get a rush of blood to the head when it's so hard to get that forward connection. Just a lack of discipline on execution there.
Crowd involved in this game. Good to see. Or good to hear.
Advantage of structure, we attack.
Both of you.
Ah, this is very good from the Diamonds.
Australia!
There's the work from Joe Weston. Closing speed, brilliant. She can smother a goal attack like no one else.
Contact goal shooter.
Another offensive contact against Bassett. So huge opportunity here for the Silver Ferns. They must make it count.
And look, they're almost static.
Well, Paige Hadley is doing a great job at denying circle edge access to Saunders. And it's a little bit laboured.
Contact.
So I guess that is the change, isn't it?
It's in the circle.
Lisa Alexander's made. Hadley on for Price.
Australia have definitely done their homework. They can see that Bailey Mez is trying to come out on lead through that middle channel. And a couple of occasions, Paige Hadley's been sitting there and shutting it down.
Center outside.
Great shot.
Beautiful with Folau. Certainly, though, she is running very close to that three-second call. Got one earlier in the first half.
Well, she's bagged 20 out of 22 at 91% and obviously having to work extremely hard.
That was brilliant from Watson to keep that alive.
Great defence. Really squeezing the pressure ball side. And they come away with it.
Rory gets New Zealand going again. And Saunders actually finds herself in a bit
contact
of space.
Windy fence, left arm.
And that's been the trouble, hasn't it? New Zealand really hasn't found any space, or very little.
No, and they're probably not doing enough work off the ball. They're quite happy to sit on a body. That's a costly turnover. They needed that.
And that was a total misunderstanding between Folau and Mez.
Goal shooter. Goal shooter, adjust your timing.
Mez told to adjust her timing.
Vantage obstruction, goal attack.
Oh, it's open at the post.
Oh, good hand, Steph Wood. And she's been good today.
New Zealand.
She's shown really good form in this World Cup. I think a lot of people were maybe predicting Gretel Tippett might get the start at goal attack, but obviously the tried and true trio of Brown, Wood and Bassett, two times premierships with Sunshine Coast Lightning. They know each other well, particularly under pressure. Beautiful triangle play by the Diamonds.
Yeah, that's too easy for Australia. And this is a bit of a lesson here for New Zealand. They've come through these early stages of this tournament relatively easily, but not today.
Advantage of structure wing attack.
Corpora, brilliant.
So Mez on lead, but again has to go back, losing the advantage to try and punch forward. Bruce all over her.
Wow, that ball deemed to have come off New Zealand.
That's it. Outside.
Over the past 2 years, Courtney Bruce has absolutely come on in that goalkeeper position.
Contact, goal attack.
Oh, another chance.
From Rory. This time, can they make it count?
Manage your side, Sanella.
Oh, great coverage from Bruce. Just confused that space. No avenue to the shooters.
Contact goal defense. No.
Well, halfway mark, third quarter. You can see Mez fired up. There's where it came from.
Structural wing defense. Center third.
Rory. In that slide position at wing defence. Quick hands between Saunders and Folau.
Good choice from Maria Folau. Bailey Mez was there. And I think one thing they need to make sure they do is that Bailey Mez keeps putting the ball through the hoop. So give her the opportunity to shoot the goals. Keep the confidence high. Smart choice from Folau. Brown just hanging off the circle edge. She's looking for the opening to punch her way through. It eventually opens. Oh, Watson! Well, Caitlin Bassett had a cup of tea and then picked up the ball.
I think she was tying her shoelaces or something. Looked up and there was the ball.
Goodness.
Watch this.
Yep, a quick lift in and off she goes.
That's hilarious.
Well, Ekenasio's back onto goal attack now for the Ferns. So Folau takes a seat on the bench. What kind of impact can Ekenasio have? Wow, from the bench into a long bomb. That's how you make your mark.
Hold time. Sense pass check, please.
Now they're just going to make sure that this is going the correct way. It is 35-29. Australia still in charge.
Goalkeeper obstruction.
Oh, we move right up into the goal circle.
Just in here.
On the top of screen, some more Silver Ferns getting ready to enter the game. Perhaps Karen Berger into the wing defence role. I thought she might get the nod at halftime based on the brilliance of Kelsey
Contact
Brown.
In the middle, where she is now, please. Thank you. Fanny's contact wing defence and offside. Contact goal defence. You're pinning her on the post.
Mez adds the extra. And, of course, this big game between England and South Africa. That's the last one coming your way today. And Jamaica will not feature in this year's semi-finals.
Well, both teams are probably going to want to avoid playing England in the semi-final with a home crowd advantage. So they're really going to want this one, probably anticipating that England might get over the top of South Africa if that's their thought process.
Interesting, though. South Africa beat England, didn't they, in the last quad series?
Absolutely, their bogey team. There's no question about that. So many great games on offer today.
Well, Mayer's going very nicely in this circle. And there you can see Karen Berger now on at wing defence. You just wondered about it, Dan, and here she is.
Which is a little bit more of a tight marker than Rory in that wing defence role. Obviously, they're playing in their traditional structures, but Berger can probably make Brown quite uncomfortable. And as we know, she can certainly win the ball.
Through comes Saunders.
Again, back to go forward. Just slightly off that circle edge.
So close to hell ball, New Zealand.
Oh, the work from the Diamonds in that circle, but the patience from the Silver Ferns. If you work that ball long enough, quite often it'll open.
All time into goal defense.
And now it's Casey Corpore going for the sit-down. Katrina Rory. In fact, I think it's going to be switch, looks like. No. Straight swap.
So they tried to swap the bibs over, but they didn't have enough time. So expect a call from Jane Watson in just a moment and Corpore to get into that goalkeeper position. Nolan Tarua wasting no time to change the unit.
And this is the right time to do it, isn't it? I mean, it's a game, yes, obviously it matters. But it's, not that time.
That is a great rebound from Watson. She saw the red light to say you're coming off, and look at the response. Huge rebound. Well, both of these coaches, Jen, they want to find out as much about their team, as much as they do about their opposition in this game. So why not pull the changes, see what's on offer.
Good pressure from Australia. Forced the error from Langman. She had nowhere else to go. Oh, now similarly, Joe Weston, straight back at you. Shannon Saunders. I think she's been good since she came on.
Well, it's starting to open for her, isn't it? Finding a little bit more space. And working hard on D, Bailey Mez delivering.
Only 3 minutes remaining in this third quarter. Too casual from Weston. So now we see, what do we see? We see Casey Corpua back on court, just to the right of your picture at goalkeep.
The only person that hasn't moved in a position throughout the court today, Laura Langman. So the six others have been busy in their respective positions.
Manage obstruction set up.
Nice switch.
Hold on. Wind defense, that's intentional. It's the portal.
I suspect she's the only player who hasn't changed position all tournament. This is good for New Zealand. They've got the margin back to four.
And they're winning this quarter 11-10, Jen, so they're certainly putting the pressure on the Diamonds. This game is still anyone's. Oh, Brown. That's the depth she had in the first half.
Instruction goal defense. Yeah. Advantage contact, wing defense. Advantage obstruction, wing defense. Contact coming over the top, penalty.
Shooting practice for Caitlin Bassett under the post. Just need to keep it steady, the Diamonds.
Oh, nice hesitation, if you like, from Saunders.
Contact centre. Let's go, let's go.
You can see some work from Bailey Mez off the ball when Langman's trying to get the deep second phase drive.
That's...
She's screening out. Bruce steps it up again. We're a little bit laboured through the midcourt, the Diamonds. The Ferns doing a good job at delaying their progress. Rory really smothering Wood. Oh,
what a picker! Katrina Rory!
You know what? She earned that because she made Wood work from that centre circle all the way to the edge.
Such a great story, Rory. Dropped from the Ferns, fought away back after.
Contact, goal defense.
Well, this player's all over the place. I think Ignacio took out Saunders.
So much happened in this third quarter. Great shot, Ignacio. Look at the skills from Rory. Outside arm. Sensational.
Advantage outside with defense. Full time. It's intentional contact. It's a caution.
So a caution there for Rory.
No, nope, where she is.
Australia hit 40. 30 seconds left in this third quarter.
Instruction, goal attack.
And what New Zealand haven't done particularly well is score in the dying seconds of the two previous quarters. They've given up that advantage.
Plenty of time here. 15 seconds on the clock. Just wait till it opens and attack the post. Mez from distance draws the penalty.
And slaps her hands. Oh, this is like a prize fight.
Contact goalkeeper on the body.
Ignacio has come back into this game. Wow.
That is so what New Zealand needed. You can see she is pumped. New Zealand take that quarter by two, but it's still Australia leading this clash. 40-36.
The sacred fans. We spoke to the Australian fans in the first quarter, so now we turn our attention to the Silver Fern fans. And New Zealand, they said, strong out. there's good support down below us as well. Lady, what's your name?
Nidhi. Namamo. Babigil.
Very good. Those are on your passports, I take it. How are you enjoying this game?
Oh, man. Amazing. There's
plenty of shouting and supporting going on up here. You're a bit of a veteran at World Cups, aren't you?
Yeah, I'm the old one.
How many World Cups have you been to?
This is my sixth season. Hang on,
G. Christchurch, Jamaica, Auckland, Singapore, Sydney and Liverpool. There you go. Solid round of applause, even from Australia. It's a cracking game going on here, isn't it? And New Zealand just closing that gap, and four now going into the final quarter. Two teams that know each other very well. Where do you think this is going to be won for New Zealand?
Oh, I just think we're going to play our game. Stay strong, ladies, stay strong. We're here for you.
And have you enjoyed this tournament?
Absolutely.
What do you think of the arena? You've been to several World Cups. What do you think of this arena and this atmosphere here?
It's up here.
Is it?
That's awesome.
Are they? I will take your word for it, of course. This is just on my face. Australia have the rubber green in the last 12 games, including 11 times. Is it going to be 13 times the last?
No.
What do you mean? You're not going to win?
We are going to win. We always win.
Yeah. In your heart. Very good. So how long are you up here for? Are you heading home after this?
Me, mum and auntie are staying on. We're going up to London and Paris.
Very good. So when do you head back down to New Zealand?
We're not
making
the end of next week, I think.
Okay, and what part of New Zealand are you ladies
from?
Taranaki. There you go. There's North Island? North Island, okay, very good. Alright, do you know this? No, okay, I thought you knew that. I thought you had like a... Okay, where did you play your netball?
This is Sabit,
okay, what... Oh, is this part? Okay, fair enough. And what position is that?
Okay.
Everywhere except you.
Okay,
just 15 minutes remaining in this group decider. 40-36, the Diamonds lead New Zealand. New Zealand did come back in that third quarter, but they need to do more.
So some really interesting stats here. The Diamonds at 85%, the Silver Ferns at 90%. They just need a few more opportunities. Nothing really between them. The penalty count, though, much more higher against the Australian Diamonds. Cannot wait for this final 15 minutes.
Teams out on court, eager to get going. Well, Bailey Mears, she's come on well for New Zealand. 8 from 9 at the moment. And Ekenasio, she started the game, went off, and she's come back energised. Huge cheer as this fourth quarter gets underway. Liz Watson for Australia. Heave from Western down court. Oh, Bassett can't bring it in.
Just to start, the Silver Ferns would want. Nolan Tarua claps their hands together. If they score here and have their centre pass, their tails will absolutely be up. Jamie Lee Price back onto wing defence for Australia too. So credit to Shannon Saunders, who's done a good job at just opening up some space, getting a bit of flow into the Ferns' front line. So Price back on to do a job.
Both shooters tangled in the same spot.
Well, Mez retreated on that one. She probably could have attacked it, but hey, not too bad on the backspace.
Both contact centre.
Big shot coming up. They need it.
Contact goalkeeper. Time.
Just a little bit of a hold here. Ball
just
out the back. The ball's probably exhausted. Mears adds one more big moment for New Zealand. They've now got to make sure they score off their own.
Well, it's so important, isn't it, Jen? These two goal runs in these big games. Steal the opposition centre pass. Make yours count. Gain momentum. Oh, Western. Can't afford to not bring your feet through the ball against Joe Weston. She'll make you pay.
Just going along the bottom of your screen, the Aussie lineup as it is now. Price back on court. Other than that, unchanged.
congested on ball side here. The Australians doing a good job at just keeping them squeezed in. Gee, she's a target. Bailey Mez. Oh, the rebound.
Oh, she got a good whack around the head. But then that's just life, isn't it? And the shooting circle.
Comes with the job.
Sides, both sides.
And a good choice to give it to Ekenasio. Just take your time, regroup, two-goal ball game. It's going to be interesting to see, Jen, what Lisa Alexander does if this game gets level. Will she back in her team or will she pull some changes? Because Nolene Tairua is not backing away.
That time from Bassett.
Causing contact, wing attack.
Message there for Kelsey Brown. She's picked up a couple of MVP performances during the week. Very good tournament.
That's what Saunders has done really well. The pass and cut to the circle edge. And when that ball comes to the edge quickly, it gives the shooters confidence. And Ekenasio, gee, she has come back onto this court with absolute conviction. Sign of a good player.
Beautiful view down court. You can see what Joe Weston sees.
Oh, unlucky Kiwis. Big shot from Steph Wood.
Contact on the ball. Instruction first, arms, both of you.
Back to three. 42-39.
Good 2-on-1 from the Diamonds on that centre pass, just denying the access to Saunders.
Wing defence instruction.
In Australia, they're doing a great job, aren't they, of pinning outside. New Zealand to that sideline.
Contact goal defence.
Well, you'd feel that benefit from a really wide opening from Laura Langman, perhaps, contact into the opposite pocket just to split the defence open.
Step it back where it was. Yes.
But they're happy to chip through the pressure and absorb it well.
Well, Ekenasio looks a different player since she's been out on court for the second time.
Well, sometimes that's all it takes, Jen, just to get out of the game, refresh the mind, have a look at it, and then get out there and go again.
Well, the defense chant goes up. Casey Corcoran answers the call.
Well, she was looking for that. Bassett set that ball in the air. There was no hope of that landing in the hand of a diamond. This is a huge play.
Instruction in defence. Outside.
Can they make it count, the Silver Ferns? Ekenasio. Confident. Very confident.
One goal in it. 10 minutes remaining. And this is how it started.
You know, that's the worth of Casey Coppola when the moment's there. Oh, crucial. An offside call.
Well, some of the umpiring decisions being roasted here, but you can imagine the pressure these umpires are under. They are doing the best they can.
Well, the Diamonds are now mindful of Casey Coppola.
Oh, she's replayed the ball.
My goodness. She is lifting.
A little bit of luck all round.
Well, that could be the one that got away for the Ferns. Just a costly error.
Contact, backwards, one. Come forward, goalkeeper.
Casey Corcoran, bit of gamesmanship there. Trying to draw Bassett back. No such luck. Back to three.
Again, Mez on extension, coming out of the circle, opening the play. Back to go forward.
Advantage offside, wing defence.
It's such a Nolene Tairua trait, the reset. Go back, keep possession. Recycle the ball.
Got to say, Mez perhaps lucky there, elbowing her way through past Bruce.
Oh, beautiful shooting. Textbook technique, sky high.
obstruction outside. Outside.
So Rory called on the edge of the circle, all on Corpua. Easy for Bassett.
They're the ones that do hurt the Silver Ferns when there's that penalty that releases the pressure. They're a defensive unit that needs to keep that pressure building and applying to eventually win the ball.
Oh, Ekenasio did well there. Looked like Bassett was going to grab it. And not Bassett, forgive me, Bruce.
And the confidence too from Langman to let go of that feed. Lucky to get through.
45-43, just about halfway in the last quarter.
Oh, good ball, great strength from Bassett. Gee, she's hard to move.
Bring it back to the head.
Just need to open the other side.
Contact wing defence.
It was smart from Berger, just hurled it almost over her shoulder to Rory. Pulse teammate.
Contact wing defence. So obstruction. Contact goalkeeper. Yes.
So this to put them in front by two in this quarter. Not to be.
So the miss from Ekenasio. How costly will it be?
Oh, Langman.
Ah, and a tiny from Ekenasio. So she's fixed up her own error.
Contact goal defence.
Gee, you got to take your hat off to these senior Silver Ferns players. When they need to produce something, they do. Langman, Kopua. The big shot from Ekenasio. Good response.
Diamond's breaking goal defence.
Diamond's just hanging tough here.
And that's a lovely save. Australia, though, still on the front foot, 46-44.
Wood just patient, rolling the front of the circle, trying to open Bassett. Gets herself a metre closer.
Shots your goalkeeper.
Good patience.
And he's breaking goal
up
attack.
To 80% now, Steph Wood. Oh, Langman covers ground exceptionally well.
Yeah, Ekenasio, it almost always looked as though it had too much on it. Did well to regather. Two goals, 47-45.
How good is it to see these two countries go head-to-head again
contact
in a typical Diamonds v Silver Ferns clash.
Hold time. It's in the centre third.
And it's not even a final.
And that's the weird thing. Certainly feels like one.
Contact wing defence. Bandage offside.
Almost from Kopua again. Bassett rock solid.
Up go the Australian bench just to keep limbered up. Berger coming through to help.
Contact.
So Bruce will have to stand down well away yes. from the danger zone. What can Saunders do?
Advantage obstruction with defence.
Not too much as it turns
contact
out.
On the ball. Inside. Just step back. Yes, goal attack, thank you.
Nez has the arm up, she's ready for the offload. Ekenasio backs herself. Maybe should have offloaded that one because Bruce has made them pay.
She has. Real opportunity here for Australia to extend that lead even more.
Contact wing attack.
Steph Wood getting involved. She wants the ball in her hand just to create the play for the Diamonds. Bit too much on that offload.
Forced a mistake.
Yep, they're let off the hook here, the Silver Ferns. Again, Langman, the confident feed over into the backspace.
A deep breath before the shot from Ekenasio. Back to two. New Zealand need possession.
Wood all alone.
Contact. Centre third. Vantage obstruction. Wing attack.
It's good again from the Diamonds. The Bassett drive just squeezes in the zone in the middle channel, opens the wide lane, and they can connect through to the circle.
Of course, Bassett and Wood, such an understanding. Used to play, of course, together at Nolene Taurua's Lightning.
Goal attack.
No longer in that pairing. But they've got a nice understanding.
Contact wing defense.
Just saw on screen Nolene Taurua having a chat to Jane Watson, who looks like she's going to get back out there in goalkeeper. Nolene Taurua just trying to change the dynamic, see if she can win some ball.
Obstruction goalkeeper.
They're still in this game, but they're running out of time.
Contact
and they desperately need a turnover.
All time. Injury goalkeeper.
If you need a turnover, Jane Watson just may well be your woman. She comes on for Casey Corpora, and Maria Folau is back on court.
Advantage obstruction
at goal shoot. So the shooting circle back to where it started for New Zealand.
Well, there'll be less passing around in that circle for the Ferns now. Get it to Maria, turn and shoot, take your chances. And Watson, obviously, great at flying at the ball, and they need to take some hits here. Oh, just like that! Oh, my goodness, Jane Watson.
That is what she does.
This is timely. Can they reward the effort of their keeper? Ekenasio wants a closer shot. Oh, Maria was free. Great commitment to the ball from Langman.
Well, Langman's on her knees.
One time, please.
She's probably winded.
Just wipe the court there for me.
That's a nice touch. Give Joe Weston a bit of a pat. You're right, mate. Oh, you're right, love, as they say in Liverpool.
That's right. 1:50 on the clock. This to get it within one. And then it's the Ferns centre pass.
Oh, this is thrilling. This is thrilling. 49-48.
Well, the crowd is right in this now. Folau, a long way from home. This passage of play to level it up. Ekenasio.
We're all square. 49-all. Taurua on her feet. I should remind you, if it's a draw, Australia finish top, superior goal difference.
The Ferns need to fly at this ball. They need to take a chance to win this game. The Diamonds just chip away and find Bassett.
Bassett's on the floor.
On the ball.
Oh, Wood, a clear shot at goal here. Plenty of time for the response, though, from the Ferns.
Australia 50. New Zealand 49. Moments remaining.
What a contest. Good pressure from the Diamonds. They're pushing them up the court. Every ball. Accumulated pressure in Jamie Lee Price.
Hold time.
And that time. Ticking, ticking, ticking.
Folau out on lead again. Ekenasio. Oh, Bruce.
Time held again as the ball's regathered from the back.
Advantage contact centre.
Oh, Langman just turning away. She's looking for the draw rather than the win for the Diamonds, perhaps.
Folau on the floor. A draw is okay in this game. A draw will count.
Folau.
Australia win 50-49 in the most spectacular of fashions.
Gee, the Silver Ferns threw everything at the Diamonds. Nolene Taurua changed just about everything. Amazing.
And what's so, well, fascinating from a point of view of numbers, Dan. First half, all Australia. Second half, New Zealand take it, the 2 second quarters. What a game, what a match, and it just adds, doesn't it, to the rich history between these two countries.
Well, I think too for the Silver Ferns, although they didn't win that match, they're going to get a lot of confidence, and also for the Diamonds too, because they've run a seven with a couple of subtle changes, but they've got the job done and weathered the storm.
I absolutely agree.